Taipei City, 2.6 million residents, each averaging 5,000 steps per day. That's 1 billion steps taken in an area of only 272 square kilometers. As a traveler, it's always interesting to see where my steps take me, but I've noticed that they tend to migrate to wherever the fun and food are. Can you blame a girl? Luckily for me, Taiwan is a wealthy nation, rich in natural landscapes, compassionate people, engineering genius, and of course, a plentiful supply of scrumptious, mouth-watering foods. Combine all of these, add an iconic Taipei building for good measure, and you get the Taipei 101, designed to be like a city within a city. With its own city square, lifestyle avenue, designer walk, and grand market, you don't have to go far to enjoy a full day of entertainment. You don't have to go far, horizontally that is. I certainly recommend going as far as you can, vertically. Funny thing about tall things, be it buildings, mountains, or whatever, I always have to get to the top of them. And here, not only do I have a great view waiting for me, but a nice prize in the form of yummy gourmet food. So you've been with us long enough to know that Taiwan is lots of fun, and sometimes a little bit feng or crazy. Well, this time, we've decided to take things up a notch, quite literally. I am sitting 388 meters above this. This being Taipei, the capital of Taiwan. The cars are this big. The view is gorgeous. That we don't need to argue about. Now, my favorite, the food. Fine dining with a gorgeous view. I could get used to this. Now, if I can only remember which fork to start with. My charm school teacher would be very proud. But in all honesty, cutlery isn't what distinguishes the meal. Anyone who has ever wrapped their own spring roll and then enjoyed eating it with their hands knows exactly what I mean. What distinguishes this particular dining experience for me is that it's not even the afternoon yet, and I'm already sipping on a flute of champagne and forking fusion cuisine into my belly. This meal has been expertly fashioned by international chefs and travels to my plate first by its own personal elevator up one of the tallest buildings in the world, and then by way of a very polite and professional young man who happens to be my server.
非常喜欢。而且中午的话，其实吃的话就是比较简单一点点，然后可能喝一点点气泡酒，然后整个今天的精神都来。都嗨起来了。对对对对。谢谢谢谢，我吃的非常过瘾。谢谢。谢谢。
So, there are lots of tall buildings in the world, and you can definitely have a very nice meal in a lot of places. But combine those two, a great meal, a tall building with a great view, in a place that is famous for earthquakes, now that is what makes eating here a unique dining experience. Like I said, I could definitely get used to this. Who says I can't do luxury? That little smug remark is going to come back and kick me in the butt later this trip, isn't it? So much to eat, so little time. My stomach certainly isn't large enough to taste all the delicious foods that Taiwan has to offer. From the top of the 101 all the way to the local street vendors, I'll pretty much eat anything. So, what's next on the menu?
While food feeds the body, love feeds the soul. So here's a love story. Once upon a time, a man who was deeply in love with his wife dedicated his life to build a symbol of his passion, the Taj Mahal Palace. In another time and space, another emperor had the passion to collect beautiful fine art pieces from four dynasties. Living through true love, they each found immortality.
Isn't this grand? Welcome to the National Palace. Can you believe this place holds over 600,000 imperial artifacts, including calligraphy, paintings, sculpture, ceramics, and more? And they all belong to one man, the emperor himself. But now, they belong to me, and you, and everybody else, because it's been open to the public so we can all enjoy the treasures. And now I'm gonna present to you one of the most prominent and interesting pieces. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the jadeite cabbage.
If you think that this jadeite is famous for its exquisite details, think again. It takes a genius to turn the imperfections of a raw material into a masterpiece. Just as Marilyn Monroe said, imperfection is beauty. As I continue my stroll in the museum, its musty smell of old history textbooks take me away on a time travel. I can almost hear the creases of the papyrus. It makes me want to tiptoe in silence to match the palace's residue of the emperor's aura. Sophistication and delicacy.
Whoa! I'm standing in front of an antique cauldron. But it's not just any cauldron. There are 500 characters inscribed inside, making it the longest bronze inscription in the entire world.
And also, it holds the key for archaeologists to study the origin of the Chinese character, which to me looks like scribbles and doodles from the Mayan or Egyptian language. Experts call that hieroglyphics. Every character has a meaning. So that's probably why the Greeks equate hieroglyph with sacred writing. My eyes have been slightly open, but I'm just scratching the surface. With education comes deep appreciation. I'm going to find Paging, who's got a lifetime supply of knowledge.
Mm-hmm. 国立故宫博物院来讲，我们的收藏是全世界第一，在这里我们可以看到一二三四五件，这件莲花四温碗全世界只有这一件。哇哦！那这个水仙盆呢，它上面完全没有任何的开片，这种瓷器是叫做青瓷，三道青瓷。对，那对这个青瓷有一种想法，他们认为最好的青瓷的颜色呢，就是要像
I'm not going to pretend I can tell the difference between my dinner plates and these masterpieces. But I do know that in my newfound appreciation for things made from the heart, we've become numb in this fast-paced, fast-food culture. Sometimes a visit to the past makes us treasure our present more.
Surf's up! When we come back, Janet learns the proper way to do a faceplant in the water while trying to look cool. Don't touch that remote!
Welcome back, and breathe. The first step to wellness is getting back to your breath, and there's nothing sweeter than breathing in fresh mountain air. Second step to wellness is how we nourish our bodies. Lucky for us, Yangming Mountains is a breath away and just a bite away. The combo of fresh air and exercise makes me hungry. And after awakening our senses and qi, the right foods will only enhance our vibrancy. Nowadays, we've forgotten the art of chewing, and we basically just wolf down our meals. Environment can make or break our digestive process. The healing nature of the space brings me into an instant state of grace. The warm medicinal aroma of the soup is giving my nose a healing massage. I'm looking forward to seeing my old friend, the master of medicinal soups.
Hi, Hi, Nadia.
Hello.
对，很沉淀。我一进来我觉得有平静，我心就平静下来，然后就很想在你外面那边阳台做瑜伽，然后看看风景。阳明山这是台北市的后花园嘛，但是咱一般拢路过较侪。啊，我是伫遮生活，因为我爱爬山啦、散步啦，啊，踮遮啉汤吼，对身体也是迄个啊做精神，伊足紧会恢复，啊，元神嘛继续光彩。 其实我同我看是看春夏秋冬的变化吼，迄个规粒山咧吼，规粒山咧，敢若像迄个水彩画吼，迄个也做色彩拢无同。
Score! I can't wait to taste this delicious medicinal soup, hot pot with lots of good medicine to help me become a healthier person. I feel so zen when I walk in here. I can't wait to feel zen inside as well. Can't wait, yummy.
Om Shanti Shanti. We have many languages for peace, and making this soup has become my friend's meditation. The secret ingredient is love. Put that in any food or drink and ignite your agni, the inner fire that brings us to a more vibrant self.
Nandia, 这个就是25年来我一直在钻研的一锅汤，硬炖羹汤。
它这样子要炖多久？
前后要8个小时。
你里面放什么东西？为什么要炖？
这里面有50种中药材哈，它会随着春夏秋冬，季节变化不同，而会改变或者是微调，它里面的处方。那一定要来，你来一定要空腹，空腹先喝3碗汤。
三碗要先喝汤，然后再吃菜，是不是？
对对对，很香哈。
It tastes kind of, let me taste again. It's really hot. Whoa. Like the medicine herbs is really strong. I can't even describe it, but it feels really nourishing. 我不知道是甜还是甘还是。
那是植物性的蛋白质。对，都是甘甜。那这50种中药材都是我在大陆，在云南、贵州、四川一带哦，收集一些野生的中药材。然后回来，有的要九蒸九晒，有的要1年蒸一次，晒一次，然后连续要9年。哇！对啊，所以这个应该算很珍贵了。我25年来就一直在弄这个汤。
Yeah, you heard right. If this man can make healing soup for a quarter of a century for his pure devotion towards helping people stay healthy, then I need to re-examine my idea of discipline.A bowl of chicken soup is a universal cure for sickness. This philosophy isn't so far from the Indian Ayurvedic medicinal system, where what food you eat is specific to your body constitution, and food is used to heal and nourish rather than deplete. I truly believe that all medicine can be found in nature, from air to herbs to water. One of my favorite ways to heal is also here in the mountains. Remember Turkish baths?Well, it's been around for centuries, and back in the day, before facelifts, this was their only spot available. Since Taiwan is hot spring heaven, and we are on a journey of wellness, it's time to indulge in some self-pampering. Water plus minerals plus 55 degrees equals detox soup / fountain of youth. Perfect skin, I am ready for you.Oh, let's take a moment to thank the Yangming Mountain Volcano Gods for this beautiful gift. So, it's a beautiful day here in Taiwan. And what else do you do except come to Xingbeitou, which is a district far away from Taipei City. And here, it's in a mountaintop with lots of fresh hot springs. And as you can see, it's a public place, co-ed.Men and women can enjoy together. And honestly, it's great, because this is what they do during the weekdays. They socialize. This is their communal spot. They just get healthy by soaking in the hot springs, and then they get to know each other again and catch up on their grandsons. There's no way to understand the local unless I'm with the locals, so I'm going to get to know them.
So Taiwan is a tropical island that has plenty of activities that you can do all around the coastline. You can go surfing, there's some great diving, but don't forget about the water that's on the island. You can even do activities like this, wakeboarding all year round. Let's do it! I'd like to take this moment to personally thank the editors for splicing in a few images of the professionalsto visually trick the viewers into thinking that it's actually me on the water doing all those tricks. If only it were so easy. And we have takeoff. You'd think that standing up would be easier. I think I'm starting to not get the hang of this.One hand. There's nothing like some 20 degree water slapping you in the face at 30 miles per hour to humble you. Nothing quite like a dip in the water to wake up your senses. No wonder it's called wakeboarding. Now the only problem is how to make yourself from looking like a dumpling in the water to looking like you're hanging ten. Oh, oh, I'm exhausted. Oh, that was fun though. Okay. That deserves a round of applause.
Vibrant body, clear mind, and an ever humble heart will open our eyes to the infinite creative intelligence that exists around us. This mecca for youth culture explodes with this vibrant and colorful energy.
Welcome to Ximending, also known as the Harajuku of Taipei. This place is where the young, hip, and trendy hang out. Very popular for shopping, movie watching, and celeb watching. Pop singers love giving mini concerts here on the streets. Did you know that the theater district in Ximending has existed since the 1930s? And in the 1950s, the theaters filled to the brim, so much so that they decided to open even more theaters. So now Ximending has over 26 theaters, 6,000 vendors, attracting over 3 million shoppers a month. Beyond the glitz, lights, and hipness, Ximending also is a melting pot of multiculturalism. Just like me, I'm all mixed up with different cultures. So today, our first stop in Ximending is going to be a sneak peek from my home away from home.
Every block in this area teases me with hints of memories, like a slideshow of snapshots of all the places I visited. Whenever I walk through a space that is so condensed with creative stimuli, I feel a surge of fresh energy.
Dun, 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 dun. Welcome to India. That's right. This is a little piece of who I am. Now, this is a shop that's very special, and it sells exotic items from South America, Nepal, Tibet, and India. Okay, let's go take a look at their items. Oh, I see what I like. Oh, incense. Whew. It smells really, really good. Now, this guy is Satya Sai Baba. He's very important. In fact, this shop is named after him, Sai Baba. And he is a revered and respected Indian guru and teacher all around the world for millions of people. And we have the same birthday. What are the chances? So, this incense is actually named after him.
A hint of sandalwood, softly printed images of Krishna, and the revered elephant god Sri Ganesha all trigger a faraway land of love, peace, harmony, and divinity, reminding me of my mantra, just for today, live in the now.
So this shop doesn't only have Indian things, they also carry exotic trinkets from all around the world, like from Peru. So these are one of my favorite things from this shop. It's a very special trinket. It's a Peruvian god of prosperity. So if you want to make more money, I guess you should get one of these. See, he's carrying some Peruvian money, some passports, so you can make more money while traveling. And let's see. Here's an airplane ticket, some milk, some candy. He's got all these random stuff. And it's said that he has very high vibrations and will bless you with big fortune. But how? You can get one of these, and you need to light him a cigarette, because if he smokes a cigarette, then he will bless you with lots of fortune. Wow, what an easy to please god of fortune from Peru.
This looks like a set straight from Bollywood. Hrithik Roshan, here I come. Mira Jan.
Never underestimate the power of film and TV. Would we really know Kazakhstan if it weren't for Bharat? Jofun if it weren't for the City of Sadness, and now recently, the district of Wanhua, thanks to the movie named after the area itself. Walking on a piece of history dating all the way back to the Qing Dynasty, this is Taipei's oldest street, Bo Pi Liao. No, you did not hear that wrong. This street is actually named Skin Peeling Hut. Random fact number two, this small district in Taipei 40 years ago had the elementary school with the most students in the world, 11,000.
Pampanga, where it all started for this capital city of Taipei, where things eventually became a red light district and is now popular again due to a famous movie. You can almost close your eyes and just remember how lively things were. Oh, you're still there? All right, come along. Like most kids, I dreamed of one day being on a real movie set, dressed up in period costume and playing out the role of some crime-fighting, building-jumping, flame-throwing superhero. But walking around on the street of Bopiliao, which has been restored to look like it did during its heyday, will do for now. Built more than 300 years ago during the Qing Dynasty, these buildings have essentially seen Taipei through its adolescence into a ripe, mature city. Ah, if only the walls could talk, the stories they'd tell. I've come here to meet up with an old friend. A movie and history buff, my old assistant cameraman, has offered to show me around his hood.
Feel 欸，有 manga 的 feel。
啊，我本来就是这里人啊，我是 manga 人啊。
哦。
对啊，那现在因为这边有一部就是在讲 manga 的电影，你现在看到这一边就是他们就是里面演员穿的戏服。
Yeah。
对啊，还有这边的陈设都是刻意模仿一个就是那种黑道大哥以前住的地方。
对啊。这种圆桌，我们现在常常看到都是大家在吃饭。但是我看这个是什么？
这个叫四色牌，类似像扑克牌那种的，对，但是是中国比较传统的。
所以这也是他们拜拜的地方吗？
对，很多人家里啊会摆这种神桌。
对啊。
对啊，然后他们都会拜，基本上都是拜祖先。可是你有没有注意到这一尊？
对，他是谁？
他是关公，历史上就是他是很重义气的。
一个 warrior 吗？
对对对。那你知道就是 Manga 这个地方就是为什么以前那么繁荣吗？
它是靠近河嘛，对不对？所以是一开始是运。
对对，它以前是港口。人家讲一府二路三艋甲，对吧？其他的一府二路都在南部，只有 Manga 是在台北的。所以说那时候这边呢，就是很多的商人啊，一些就是车夫啊，各种各式各样的人都聚集在万华这边。所以呢，常常就是比如说你是哪里来的，他们就集合在一起，变成一个组织。那这个组织那时候就常常在万华的各个地方，就是变成一股就是比较团结的力量。
Walking around the city, you do indeed notice the many themed streets snaking throughout the capital. Tattoo Street, Tea Shop Street, Wedding Dress Street. I guess the idea of ganging together is something that still continues today, certainly making it easier for the tea-drinking, tattoo-loving bride-to-be. We all have our cliques. The Fun Taiwan Crew is our little gang, and we do some shooting of our own. With cameras, of course.
像你现在看到的这一些啊，就是我们当时啊前人们生活的一个足迹，包括你刚走过的剥皮寮历史街区啊，还有现在看到的这些都是很老的一些，甚至现在艋甲还有一些人家里会有的摆设，很有趣，
很不错啊。现在有这种房间也真的还蛮棒的。
对啊。
So this is what you would call 景点啊台客。It's not too bad. I mean, seriously, this is great real estate. Look at the solarium and everything. 我跟我舅妈看他台子的。
我借个衬衫给你穿。
Psst! Is Fun Taiwan crossing the line? Vandalizing on public property? Nadia breaks loose after this break.Ha ha! Laughter makes a body come alive, and expression through art has the same effect, awakening these outdated historical building walls. I love color. Different colors carry particular electromagnetic energy, which vibrate at different healing frequencies. It is a universal mode of expression.
Welcome to the Bronx. Nah, we're still in Ximending. It does look like the Bronx, doesn't it? In fact, when people look at all this graffiti, they think underground art. But a district in Ximending,has an organized institution for graffiti artists, so it's no longer underground, it's legitimized. In fact, the Ximending Film Festival has invited graffiti artists to come and pay a tribute to glamorize their wall with the theme of film. Now, we're gonna meet one of the graffiti artists in charge of painting the walls. Hey, Guan, what's up? So cool, is this your work?
Yeah, this is our team's work here.
So how long have you been painting graffiti?
Off and on for about 10 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So So I thought that actually painting graffiti is you do it at the night and then you run off. Uh-huh. It's like all like illegal and stuff. But here it's organized, isn't it?
Yeah, there's different forms of graffiti. And for today, we're doing some graffiti for the public space.
So could I play as well?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I think it would be pretty fun.
Yeah.
I mean, since it's legal and stuff.
Yeah, there's a lot that you can help me with here.
All right, let's go take a look at your stuff. Gosh, you know, this garage door is like mad ugly. I mean, these walls are just ugh. But because of graffiti, it kind of looks good now. I mean, you don't even notice there's a garage door.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy.
That's the power of art.
I know, power of graffiti art.
Yeah, graffiti art. So first thing we're gonna do is we'll have you help fill in the yellow.
Okay.
For the piece. And you can use this yellow here.
All right. Yes, power.
So think about when you were younger and you were coloring in coloring books.
Okay.
What you do first is you'll outline.
Okay.
You outline it and then you fill it in.
Ooh.
So actually, let me show you.
Okay.
So with this, so you just trace over it.
Okay.
And then afterwards, you fill it in.
Oh my God, this is so exciting.
One of the better ways to fill it in is to use your whole body to move from one side to another, so you get a really nice clean strokes. So you can start and you move your body.
Oh.
Because if you only move your arms, the range is more narrow. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, it's kind of like dancing, huh?
Yeah.
I'm like dancing. Ooh.
Artists create from an inner empty space, shooting out spontaneous impulses, like a rising cobra snake to the movement of the snake charmer's flute. My finger gripped the spray can tip for 6 hours and moved the colors to my soul's expression.
So that's Guan and my masterpiece. Not too shabby for a first timer, eh? It's gorgeous, creative, and it's legit. Next time you come to Ximending, make sure you check this piece out. Notice the N trademark? Next time.
Where do I go to get some fresh snake soup, the tourist asks? Every local will direct you to one of the most famous night markets in Taipei. However, Hua Xijie has a darker past, one that has been given an extensive makeover.
So these are the famous small alleys of Hua Xijie. You know, back in the day, if I was to tell my grandma we're visiting Hua Xijie, even these tiny alleys with the little address and everything, she'd go, "Ayo, hey, pai zabo it." That's where all the bad girls are, because both sides used to be filled with brothels. But what has happened now is a whole team of artists, they've come together and they've actually turned this into a photo gallery. So you have outdoor photos. These are great photos of the community members who live here in the Wanhua community. It's a great way to kind of convert this old area that doesn't have the best reputation into something that's quite artistic, quite beautiful. I mean, look at this. I love taking photos of people. I think this really shows you what the character. It gives it a nice little understanding of what people are like here. Let's go check out the hotel.
An image can certainly be more powerful than 1,000 words. And the artists here use such images to tell the story of a neighborhood that is brimming with so much personality and with so many unique characters that I wouldn't know where to start aiming the camera. One thing's for sure, Hua Xijie has certainly reinvented itself from its red light district days into a popular open-air market within a picturesque and historical setting.
Hi, 欢迎.
Hi,
你好，应该是高山啊。我们对，欢迎来到我们这个徐良半岛风雨游程的老旅社。谢谢。这是高山黑五星级饭店。对，没错，对。在那个时候盖旅社，现在几乎都已经停止营业了。嗯。那能够看到很久的旅社，在万华应该是只有这一间。对。如果你喜欢看，我带你到楼上看房间。OK，好。OK，我们走。
很特别吧？其实它厕所比我那没错，其实它厕所是算是蛮大的，
算蛮大的。
真的比那个剥皮寮我们看的那个一套小房间差不多这么小一。
而且更舒服，它什么都有。对啊。对对，如果你从窗户看出去，到晚上的时候，对面的茶馆啊会唱歌，然后又看到霓虹灯闪闪进来的灯光。
对。
这个我觉得就是。
它闹钟起取经，因为它巷子里面其实到晚上茶那个茶店啊，它到晚上就会歇息了， yeah. 就不会营业，所以非常安静，因为离那个夜市还有一段距离。对。
This is like a backpacker's dream hotel. I mean, you're so close to the MRT, so it's very convenient. You have the night market right downstairs. Not only that, you're actually staying in a historical hotel. I think there's actually a movie that's been filmed in this very room. So if you know if you're a movie buff or you just like being where everything's really really real now, as we say in Chinese, this is kind of a cool place to stay. Lots of history.
Knowing the history of this hotel certainly opened my eyes.But that's got nothing on what I'm about to see. This hotel boasts of an expert in creating semi-anatomically correct origami out of blankets, or anatori blankigami, as I like to call it.
Wow! Oh, 谢谢谢谢 Okay, this is not at all what I was expecting. You know, when they say folding blankets, I was expecting, you know, what you see in normal five-star hotels, just a blanket like that with the edge kind of folded over.
阿哥，我奇怪，
竹子，竹笋嘛，对不对？我形容是韩籍，
好买晒啦，
买些韩籍。
我觉得像手卷。
对啊，啊这是肉掌，
肉掌买晒够，香蕉嘛可以说。
香蕉
就是吃的啦，就是这样子嘿。
今天真厉害耶，所以这物件拢是你家己想起来，啊家己去安尼算。
对。哦
，Ladies and gentlemen, this lovely lady is going to fold for us.A gluteus maximus. I don't know how she does it. 哇，那里客户应该进来时阵，那款有时阵逛到哇，怎么那玩呢？
稍微点下去，小屁股，
屁股啊！
上次有个女生客人来，
有像吗？
有，这个裤子脱掉就有两个扣啊，都没有。
I love this lady. Oh my god, this is so cute. There you go. There's my gluteus maximus. I failed origami class when I was 5 years old. I think I just failed my blanket folding butt making course.
Next up, yep, it's shopping, but not as you know it. Find out why after the break.
Ooh, mysterious.
Men are from Mars and women are from Taipei. For men, shopping is simple. You need something, you go to the store, you buy it, you go home. For women,Shopping is an art form, a social event, and sometimes even stress management therapy. Taipei City offers all this, and as I'm about to discover, a little bit more.
We women, we like to look good. And to the shugen of many husbands, boyfriends, and even fathers out there, that unfortunately means we like to go shopping.But don't forget about internal beauty. Now for that, I highly recommend getting a good night's rest, drinking lots of water, and of course, getting a good workout in the mornings, or even in the evenings. Now, I'm a little bit lazy, so I like to kill two birds with one stone. So luckily, we're gonna go visit this new mall where you can go on a bike and shop at the same time. It's gonna be the only place where you're gonna see me in heels on a bike in a mall and have it look actually kind of normal. Okay, let's go.We women are always looking for excuses to go shopping. So I'd like to take the time here to thank Taipei for providing us gals with yet another reason to get our retail therapy on. Anything that cuts out the gym time gets a gold star in my book. There's only so much shopping one can do on the saddle, however. I'm going to need to at least try on the stuff that's going to max out my credit card after all.What I tell you, they think of everything. Parking spot for a bicycle, you get a great workout, even a little stretch. Now, for that shopping.
Once you've parked your bike, the setting gets a little bit more laid back and luxurious as you slinker into some designer jewelry and dresses from the top international brands.There's even a special undie area, or knickers as some strangely call it, where you can get to play the princess in a decadent boudoir-themed room, enjoying the full-on special treatment from your very own personal assistant.
This to me is how shopping should be. You don't have to do anything. You just sit on a nice, cushy little couch, and the shopping comes to you. Excuse me. This is a private viewing. All right. If I give you a little peek, will the ratings increase? This is a family show. Bye-bye.
Carrie Bradshaw of Sex and the City joked that shopping was her cardio. Evidently, she's not the only gal who likes a good retail workout. According to a recent study, the average woman spends 399 hours and 46 minutes shopping each year. If it were a 9-to-5 job, shopping time would add up to nearly 9 years of retail therapy over a lifetime, or an average of 301 shopping trips per year. I'm an amateur by these standards, and I've got a lot of catching up to do.
I don't know how you do it, girls. It's exhausting walking around looking and shopping and all these different designers, local designers, some foreign designers. You don't know where to start. You definitely don't know where to end. Just give me a little break. This is a nice chair. It's kind of comfy.
Whether you're a traveler between shopping malls, cities, or continents, we are all explorers of the world around us. From the moment we step out the door, we begin exploring, from which route to take to which items to buy. A girl has got to take advantage of Taipei's extensive public transportation. Next stop, an adventure of treasure hunting. We all know that shopping burns calories, but how about double that?
So you see, this is the kitchen section. You need anything in your kitchen? Ooh, look, guitar. Doesn't get that cold in Taipei. This is so fun. Isn't this creative? You can style yourself in any way you want to. Oh, a water warmer when it's cold. Ooh, no way. Surfboard for 9,800 NT. That's kind of cheap. I think this is one of the good quality of surfboards. Pumps from Nike.
Goodbye to looking high and low for things. We've got one humongous closet with gadgets and gizmos aplenty, from bobby pins to CDs to shoes, tape recorders to brand name bags, jewelry, comics galore. Living amongst hipsters from New York taught me how to walk outside of the box and exist beyond trends. Dare to be original.
Golf, anybody? They even sell golf clubs here. And piano keys. Da-na-na-na-na-na. And the trumpet. So whatever you want to try in your New Year resolution, anything you want, they've got it here. So if you've got anything that you don't want anymore, there are hand-me-downs, you're sick of it, that's your garbage, but it's someone else's gold. So bring it here to a secondhand shop so other people can share it. It's very eco-friendly, and it's fun for people like me. So dig out your own treasures. Okay, I'm gonna go back and look some more because I think I'm gonna go back with a couple of luggages of stuff. Yay!
Stressed out, need to run into a wall, slam somebody on the head with styrofoam perhaps? You don't want to miss out what's in store for you after the break.
Illumination, poise, concentration would be the recipe for the birth of any new beginning. If 101 could be built from a person's imagination, just imagine what infinite possibilities we have yet to awaken. And everything begins with one breath. And in that stillness, we can take our first step. Everything else falls into place. After sun saluting to the beautiful sunset on Elephant Mountain, I'm ready for Taipei in the moonlight.
Gosh, I feel so relaxed. I mean, I had such a healthy day. Healthy in body and in spirit. Wait a minute. I think there's something missing. What about healthy in the mind? Ooh, that one's hard.
But we can make it easy. It's all about perspective. I can either be force-fed knowledge and just swallow information from someone else's opinion, or I have the freedom to appreciate this Taipei Fine Arts Museum through my inner stillness and go on an experiential journey. This Taiwanese Tate is famous for having the most number of contemporary artworks in the entire world, as well as supporting up-and-coming local young artists by showcasing their talents. The museum is designed to look like a pub, but this is a more conscious choice on a Saturday night. How many opportunities do you get to visit the museum at night? Let's pretend we're the Night of the Museum 3.
Ooh, peekaboo. Okay, this place is supposed to be like a white canvas and you can make any home you want. This museum is special. I mean, you don't just stand there looking at stuff. You actually have to crawl down and look at these unique little houses that people have built. Everyone has their dream home. What's yours? This is kind of a small dream home. Yeah, I know. Oh, sexy lady. Let's just crawl. This is good exercise. Wow, this is funny. Minimalist. All we need is a bed. Okay, I think I'm done looking at dream homes. My dream home, definitely standing.
Oops, sorry that you had to see my thong. I guess that is pretty contemporary too. I thought I'd become an exclusive edition. Besides, with contemporary art, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. You see a mountain, I see an Oreo.
Not so boring for a museum, eh? Now for the next healthy thing, sleep.
Taipei is like New York, Hong Kong, Tokyo. Open 24 hours, it's a city that never sleeps. Since I'm on an adrenaline binge today anyways, I'll check out just that one last thing before heading to catch some Z's. Why does that always seem to be my last thought before finding myself up until the sun rises here in Taipei? Adventure is an imported one, all the way from the exact opposite side of the world, Buenos Aires. So put on your heels, your boots, your dancing, your walking shoes on. Taipei's nightlife is one that involves lots of screaming, yelling, dancing, styrofoam, and overall rowdiness. And this is before the alcohol. For those not so accustomed to this kind of sensory overload, don't worry. There's plenty of other parties, karaoke TV, night markets, and nightclubs that is far less frantic than this. This place is just a great example of how there truly is something for everyone here.
million people, 1 billion steps per day. Where are your 5,000 steps going to take you next?
All you need to do is take that first step. You never know who or what you may come across.